What's going on YouTube? This is DJ Buster B. I got some more stuff that came in today. I'm gonna start off with, got another set of these DMX wireless transmitter and receiver kits. And so far I have six of these things and they actually work real great. And this is the Series C. Got a few other videos on YouTube about them. But so far I got six. I have one transmitter and the rest are all receivers. So with different lighting around your room, you can link them up wirelessly and everything. You don't have to worry about a lot of cables going across doorways and things like that. But these things actually work pretty great. So there's another one I got. And the next piece of equipment that came in is something that I've been looking at for a while, trying to make a decision on what to get. But it's a moving head. And this is a 30 watt LED moving head right here. A little screen right here for DMX channels and some other features and everything. This 30 watt, and I didn't get it from United States. I got this one directly from China because, you know, they make all this stuff over there and they just put a different name on it. But see the little manual right here, it's a 30 watt moving head. This one has, can't remember how many gobos offhand, but this 30 watt, I'm gonna try it out, see how this thing is with it. Ordering from China, gotta tell you, this guy was fast. It came in 5 days. From China all the way here to Virginia, United States. Here's the box that it came in. You can see right here. Straight from Hong Kong. Came DHL. And see, here's the box right here. This is 30 watt, not the 60 watt. And I'm gonna hook this thing up a little bit, see how it turns out. Also, I'm gonna do, got one of these little measuring wheels right here. You know, you can roll out. I always use this for gigs when I want to find out how long cable runs I need and everything. Very accurate. I'm gonna roll this thing from my house across the street to the neighbor's house and see how many feet I have, and then I'm gonna cut this thing on like in spot mode and see if it'll make it across the street and how bright it's gonna be. So next couple clips, I'm gonna turn this thing on and see what it does. Okay, I got everything down here now. Just gotta sit on top of my pool table just for demonstration. And I got this Obey 40, which is not hooked up yet. I'm just going to turn on the AC power, but back here you can see in the back we got DMX in and out and power. Right here on the side it does say 30 watt LED spot. There's your little LCD screen right here and your standard four buttons, menu, up, down, and enter, and microphone, and plus the DMX light right there. It did come with a mounting bracket also, which you can mount on the bottom. I'm going to turn this thing on for the first time, see what happens. A little welcome on the screen down here. It's in sound active mode, I guess, from the start. This thing has cooling fan here, another one on this side here, and it has one on the back of the light also, which is right back here. Can't really follow it around, I'm trying to follow it as best I can. I didn't set anything up as far as focus because you could set the focus and everything too. Just trying to do my best to follow it around. There's another video clip. I got this thing functioning with DMX. One thing I realized is the focus, some of the 30 watt moving heads that they sell out there, let me see if I can get it to focus here, they have manual focus, but this has a focus right here just with the DMX channel 13. You got 13. If you look here at the spotlight, if I move it, it's now getting sharper, sharper, and now it's out of focus just by sliding the fader. That's very sharp right there. Oops, I don't know, I hit something here. All right, go back to my position, here we go. Okay, here's the color wheels right here. I see red, green, blue, see how it just goes right through the color wheel. And you can have it scrolling through, change the speed of it or reverse it. Speed up, slow it down, bring it back open. And here's a prism. Well, these are actually, this and that, that wasn't a prism, that was the actual gobos that are inside here. Different ones. See, like that right there doesn't look focused, but if I come over here to this next page, I could probably focus it. See, it's blurry. And now it's sharp. Yeah, I'm still trying to figure this out though, but it has, yeah, that's a cool one right there, that gobo. I'm trying to see if I can get back to that other one. All right, that gobo that I just found, the glass one that's in there, I'm gonna mess with the focus right here. Yeah, it's out of focus. Bring it back in. Out of focus again. Right up here in the middle. Just focus, I'm hitting some other faders, that's why something's jumping. But it gives you an idea that this thing is functioning pretty well. So the next couple clips, I'm gonna play around with it a little bit more. Yeah, just came from measuring from my house to exactly across the street.
You probably can't really see it. But right where that light pole is, the guy's house.
That is exactly 138.9 feet, according to my measuring wheel. So I'm about to plug this light up and just put it on spotlight and shine it across the street. YouTube, I got this light on. Now I'm about to point it directly across the street at the house. You see it's panning down. Okay, outside, that is exactly 138 feet away, and it's lighting the entire house off of 30 watt.
All right, let me go in and turn this thing off so the neighbors wonder what's going on.
Okay, that was a test of just shooting it directly across the street, 138 feet, and as you can see, the beam actually lit up the entire house, but most venues that you're in is not that far away, 138 feet, like to the back of the wall. So this thing should work pretty good in most of the parties that I'm doing or weddings. So right now I'm pretty much, I like this light, so I'll probably go ahead and order another one. That was one reason why I just ordered one from China, because I wanted to see exactly how it was. I read all the reviews and saw a lot of pictures and different videos that people had on YouTube. And after this one got here in 5 days, and so far it looks like it's good quality because everything is made in China anyway, all the lights that we normally buy, and you just put a different name on it. But I'm going to definitely get another one in a few weeks and one last look at it. And now I'm going to go ahead and start programming some DMX scenes and everything in here and see if I can get this thing to work. So later on, I'll post some more clips on how this thing looks actually running off a program. So, peace.